Jasper, and I have made it safely back home to Texas. I hope you got a chance to read the ending of the Benji and Passion wedding story so you have all of the details. I just wanted to give you my perspective as far as what happened. Here is a quick synopsis. Just as the wedding was about to start, Benji disappeared again. Everyone thought he had taken off, including me. I had already taken my place up front and was waiting for Benji to hopefully reappear. In the meantime, Passion's mystery poodle, her first true love, showed up about that time to declare his love and try to get her back. Turns out his real name was Prince Snowden Charming. Can you believe that? It was Prince Charming. Then, all of a sudden, there was a major disruption with the police chasing Prince Snowden and blowing their whistles, and I'm pretty sure there were sirens in the background, and the bagpipes were coming down the aisle with Passion, and all of the squirrels started going crazy and chattering from all the commotion and noise. The scene was total chaos and mayhem. Prince Snowden jumped the hedge and landed right in front of Passion. They quickly gazed into each other's eyes, exchanged their names, and he declared his undying love to her. The two of them obviously needed a moment. So the squirrels all jumped out of the trees and, as we say in Texas, circled the wagons around them. Auntie Bobby Squirrel took charge. I witnessed Passion and Snowden each declare their love to each other. Aunt Bobby rushed up front to me and said, "You must marry this couple, Casper. They are in love." Well, considering that I already had my doubts about the true love status of Benji and Passion after that interview, Benji's reluctance to give up his playboy lifestyle and ways, and the fact that he appeared to be a no-show again, and then mostly considering the fact there was a bossy squirrel wearing a red dress and holding a big fat purse, and an army of 250 squirrels glaring at me and chattering, I said, why not? You see, my good friend OG had tangled with a squirrel recently, and I surely didn't want to be at odds with 250 of these critters. Have you seen their teeth and claws when they're mad? Anyway, as quickly as possible, before something else happened, I asked Prince Charming, "Do you take Passion to be your wife, yada, 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 and do you, Passion, take Prince Charming to be your husband, so on and so forth, etc., etc.?" And then, with the power given to me as the Justice of the Peace and authorized by Your Majesty the Queen, I now pronounce you His Royal Highness, Prince Charming and Princess Passion. Whew! My job was done. I had to get out of there quick. There were so many tissues on hand, first from all the girls and nurses crying and sobbing that Benji was no longer available, and then later, tears of joy that he was still available. I was afraid I might lose it and tear up a whole box of Kleenexes after all the twists and turns and stress in this fairy tale romance. I do have to tell you, though, that Mama felt very sad for Benji being dumped like that at the last minute. And the fact that he left so abruptly, she thought he was embarrassed and sad. I mean, how can you compete with Prince Charming? But it turns out I spoke to Benji, and he was very happy for Passion that she ended up with her Prince Charming because he thought he would not be able to happily give up his carefree bachelor life. In British English, Benji is a bit of a lad, which translates to a ladies' man, and that he is for sure. He even made a video congratulating Passion and saying how happy he is for her and that he's off to Monte Carlo. I heard that those two caring and compassionate nurses that gave him such good care booked the next flight to Monte Carlo too. Those two nurses must be really devoted to their work. I do also want to thank my date Harmony for being such a good sport when I was really unable to spend much time with her. She ended up being asked by Passion fashion to stand up front during the ceremony because everyone was in awe of her beautiful purple dress. Well, I hope everyone enjoyed our fairy tale story about Benji, Princess Passion, and Prince Charming. I enjoyed helping bringing it to you, and as they say, they all lived happily ever after.